In my experience working with thousands of clients from around the world, working at various companies around the world, I've noticed one clear thing that has impacted many employees' ability to stay at their job and actually enjoy it. And that is most companies' wellness programs are actually not that good. Sure, they may have amazing wellness perk packages that can really entice talent to want to work at a place. But when I think about and when I see what allows an employee to stay at their company and how it's associated to wellness programs, there's one clear difference that I feel like most companies miss that can help them retain more of their employees and actually have a better, more positive work culture. I'm Thomas Edwards, creator and author of The One Up Effect, helping high-performing professionals with families have fun becoming their best self through purpose, play, passion, and performance. In this video today, I'm gonna share with you the secret that is the difference between a good wellness program and a terrible wellness program. So here's the truth. A lot of wellness programs are set up for you to take advantage of the perks. For example, you can have access to certain apps that can allow you to organize or be more productive or to alleviate stress, meditation apps. I mean, there's so many subscriptions that companies can offer you as part of the benefits of working with them. But with all the tools and all the resources that can be available to you as a perk for working at a company, it still misses the point of what human beings actually need to perform at a high level. It's that wellness programs focus on you having to take care of yourself. See, a lot of the perks that are offered to you create isolated experiences that just keeps you on your own, accountable only to yourself, and you are required to have the motivation to push through and be able to do those things, especially after a top load heavy work week. Or just a huge stretch period of time where you're just constantly working and you don't really have a lot of space to take care of yourself. And because an employee may not have a lot of time to take care of themselves, their wellness decreases, their level of happiness decreases, their level of production decreases, and their level of satisfaction at work decreases, making them realize that maybe this is not the job that they should be going for, and they decide to go somewhere else, or maybe nowhere at all. They may just leave the job just to do nothing. And feel that they can be happier than doing something else that they don't really like. But here's the thing, some people are in this situation not realizing that it's not the job that is setting them up to fail, it's that they're not supported well enough by their job to feel happy and a better sense of well-being. You see, programs that are focused on me don't tend to work as well as programs that are focused on we. When you're a part of a company, you are a part of a collective. And if one person is having an issue, the entire company is having an issue. And when you isolate people through their own journey, it can become a very lonely journey and it can impact long-term productivity and it also can impact employee work culture. Creating a wellness program that allows the collective, the company, to interact and support one another in their well-being journey can be a huge, huge added benefit. In fact, that should be the entire philosophy of wellness programs moving forward, especially now considering a lot of companies are going from working inside the office to eventually being all virtual or some type of hybrid. We still need this collaborative, collective experience that can allow people to not be isolated and feel like their well-being is tied and connected to other people. This is part of the human experience. Human beings, by natural law, need human connection. They need to feel like they're a part of a bigger purpose. And they will not benefit from being isolated and thinking that that's just enough for them to do their job and feel this sense of well-being. And so how do we do this? How do we set it up? Well, one really great start that I believe is that there needs to be space inside the work culture where employees can get together and really talk about how they can support themselves in creating a better sense of well-being, not just for the job and for the business that they work for, but for themselves. And you can do this in a myriad of ways. In fact, there's technology and there's physical space available for people to be able to get together and do that. But being able to create that space and have it there, and I would even say, you know, make it mandatory for people to come together and really share what their experience is working. What is their experience working with other people? How can they be more supportive and really make the work experience not just about one person, but about the collective? And I believe ultimately that is what's going to make and what creates top tier wellness programs and can allow people who really want to feel like they're a part of something much bigger than themselves. This is what's going to be a really key component to making that work. But this is what I think. Comment below, let me know what you think. What is your wellness program at your job? Are you happy with it? Do you feel like it could be more supportive, more inclusive, more collective focus as opposed to individualistic? Comment below. If you have an employee wellness program that you love that has more of a we vibe than a me vibe, let me know what you think. Comment below, share what that experience is. I wanna hear from you. Please like, subscribe, hit that bell, get notified when we put out videos, which happen almost every single day. And if you found this video interesting or inspiring, please share this with someone who might find this interesting or inspiring too. I'd love to hear what they have to say and get them in on the conversation. And if you want the exact process and science behind reducing stress, virtually eliminating burnout, and learning how to have fun creating more success in your health, wealth, self, family, marriage, career, business, and not feel the need to have to sacrifice your personal happiness or your professional ambition, you can go to thomasedwardsjr.com. Once again, this is Thomas Edwards reminding you to make life a game that you can win and have fun playing. Until next time, I'll see you around.